Time to play with some clay. Turning this horse upside down so I can work underneath, and I got to figure out how to do that, and I think I've got an idea of how to do that, but I got to work that out somehow, and I just thought I'd show you how I'm going to do that, and I really have no clue how I'm going to do that, because I got to turn him upside down and have him protected and yet have it supported. So I've got to take a bunch of stuff off of my sculpting stand so I can do that. Try to support the horse on these edges here, and I've cut a couple of boards to give it some room so that the head will not touch the board on the sculpting stand. I think I got it figured out. I think I do. I need to get past this head, which means I've got to have the board at least right there. And I can do it with a 1x or 2x2 or whatever this is. But I have to extend this board a little bit, and the only way I can do that is by screwing down a piece of wood onto it. Why do I make things so difficult? This one will be just fine. So now I need to line that up with the line that I made. Okay, that's one side. Now I need one for the other side. I have both these boards cut ahead of time so that they're in the right height. And now I just need to make sure to be at the same height, not at an angle. Oh, it's going to work out fine. You just have to think three-dimensional. And I'm not very good at that. The supports for the braces. I know this seems like an awful lot of work to go through for all this, but it'll be worth it. I hope. I think I know what I'm doing. I made a center mark on my table so that I can have the work obviously centered on my table. Scary part. All right, now I gotta get this light up out of the way so I'm not banging into the sculpture with it. This is when you find out whether you're armatures and good strong armature. Well, you can see just how close that came. I got it right to the tip of the ear. I'm not worried much about the ear because I plan to resculpt that. Okay, that holds it nicely. Pull that out. Up here. Yeah. Okay, it's solid. That's a relief. I knew I was going to have to do this. I just didn't know what I was going to do until I got to actually doing it. Now you can see why I had to do this, so I could get down in there and fill holes that are in there and fill a big hole that's there. I wanted to do a little detail work on the inside leg, on the inside of that robe, and work underneath the chest here. But everything is pretty solid. It's a good armature. I showed you how to make this armature for this horse in my instructional two-disc DVD set on creating a horse from scratch. This is the horse I created from scratch. All right, that's gonna be it for today, and I'll pick this up next week, Monday. I've got some people coming by Tuesday, so I'd like to get this bottom part of the horse done before then so I can put the lady back onto the sculpture. But this will be fine until I come back. It doesn't harm the clay doing this. It just makes it look really strange. You can see I can fill in underneath here now and do stuff I couldn't do at the angle I was at on the regular angle. But I got it all worked out. It's really solid, and it's going to hold nicely. So, good night, everybody, and I'll see you next week. Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.